Hey everyone, and once again welcome to Google Ads course. Myself Umar Taskeer. Guys, in this particular video we are going to discuss about CTR, which is click through rate. So in Google Ads, click through rate and the concepts behind click through rate are very important. So we are going to discuss something around click through rate, and the main agenda or the topics which are there in this particular video is what is click through rate. So we'll be starting with the basic definition that what is click through rate, and then we'll be moving to what is Google CTR, right? And then industry-wise average CTR, or what CTR we can say that it's a good CTR, right? So we'll be discussing on these things, right? So let's begin. And first of all, before understanding CTR, that what is CTR and what is the importance of CTR and what are the CTR's average industry benchmarks, first of all, we have to understand two very important things, right? Which are like impressions. The first one is impression and the second one is click. So we have to understand what is impression and what is click. We have to understand, right? So first of all, what is an impression? So you see, suppose there is any user who is making a query on the Google. Suppose I'm making a query on the Google like buy online shoes. As soon as I'm making some queries over here on Google, what I will see is I'll see Google search in the result page, and I'll be seeing different results over here, right? These results will be the combination of the organic results as well as the paid results, right? So I'll be seeing some ads over here. Like I have seen this ad number one over here, and this ad number two over here, and then I have seen ad number three over here. So these are ad one, two, and three respectively. Then I'm seeing some ads over here also. There's some search ads over here also, which are like four and five. So suppose I am the user over here who was searching for buy online shoes. And as soon as I'm looking for buy online shoes, as soon as I've entered this term buy online shoes, what I'm going to say is there will be a lot of results, right? Some were paid and some were organic. So right now, as we are talking about Google Ads, we'll be ignoring the organic results. We'll not be focusing on organic results, and our main focus will be towards these paid results only. So now when I'm seeing this ad number one, ad number two, and ad number three over here, right? And if I'm going to this ad number two and I'm clicking this ad number two over here, right? So I'm making a click over here, fine. So now what happens over here is all these ads, the ad number one, two, three, and four, all these ads got impressions, but there was only one ad which actually got clicked, right? The ad number two got clicked, but other ads got only impression. So what we can say over here is impressions, right? Impressions were there for ad number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? And no clicks, right? These ads didn't got any click, and we have to remove 2 from here because 2 got a click, right? But only 1, 3, 4, and 5 got impressions and no clicks, right? So there were no clicks in this case, but only ad number 2 got one impression and a click also, right? So and what about these all ads? They got, if we segregated with respect to impression and clicks, so the ad number one, three, four, and five got one impressions each, zero clicks, whereas the ad number two got one impression and one click. So this is basically the basic difference between impression and click. So that is what written over here. An impression is a view. When your ad loads and displays in front of a user, that is one impression, right? No matter that ad is a search ad or that ad is display ad, it actually does not matters. The only thing that matters is if your ad is there in front of the user, that is basically counted as an impression, right? And what are the clicks? As the name justifies, a click simply enough is whenever a user actually clicks on your ad. The thing which we actually imagined over here with respect to ad number two, that okay, the ad number two got one impression also, and then ad number two got a click also, right? Now we will be talking about CTR. So first of all, let us discuss about the basic definition, the theoretical definition of CTR, and then we will be moving to the mathematical expression of CTR. So this number is the percentage. So CTR is, let me explain you the click-through rate. It is click-through rate. The full form of CTR is click-through rate. And what you have to make sure is whenever you see rate anywhere in any metric, it is basically a representation of percentage. So whatever you are seeing as rate is basically a percentage, right? So this number is the percentage. For example, if it is the CTR is 5, which means that I am talking about 5%. If the CTR is 6, which means that I am talking about 6%. If the CTR is 2, which means that I am talking about 2%. So this number is the percentage of the people who viewed your ad, right? The number of people who viewed your ad and then actually go on to the clicking ads, right? So actually go on making the click, right? So this is basically the ratio. Suppose, let me give you an example. Suppose there were 100 people who actually viewed our ad. So there were 100 impressions, and after those impressions, after those 100 impressions, it is very less possibility, or it is almost zero possibility that all the impressions will be result into clicks. I mean, if my ad is getting 100 impressions, there is no possibility that I'll be getting 100 clicks also, right? So for example, if there are 100 impressions and there are only 50 clicks, that too is very high, right? That too is very high, which means that the CTR over here will be 50%, right? If there are 100 impressions and there are like 20 clicks, then which means that there will be 20% of CTR. The CTR is 20%, the click-through rate is 20%. So this is the basic definition of CTR. Now if we come to mathematical representation of CTR, that how it actually looks like a formula, right? So if we want to calculate, then how can we actually calculate? So CTR is basically the percentage. So I'll be putting percentage over here, and this 100, when I'm multiplying anything by 100, which means that I'm converting it into percentage. Now suppose if we convert it into numbers, if we put some numbers over here, like total clicks on ad and total impressions. So suppose this one was my ad. This one was my ad, the ad number 2 that we made in the last PPT. Now I am creating it once again over here. There is ad number 1, there is ad number 2, there is ad number 3, and then there are 2 ads at the bottom of the page, and then there are 3 ads at the top of the page. So suppose if mine ad is this ad number 2, and on different keywords like keyword 1, keyword 2, keyword 3, right, my ad is getting impressions, right? This ad number 2 is getting impressions, and I got somewhere around, let's say, 100 impressions. I got 100 impressions, and out of those 100 impressions, I got clicks. Let's say I got 10 clicks. Fine, I got 10 clicks. Now I'll put these numbers, these imaginary, this is just there to suppose, right? These numbers are not real, the 100 impressions and the 10 clicks. This is just to explain you. So the total clicks which are made on my ad are 10 over the total impressions which were 100, and this is basically the click through, right? And when I say rate, which means that I am calculating the percentage, so I have to multiply it with 100 and I have to put my percentage mark over here, right? So we do not have to go into the mathematical calculations. I am just trying to explain the concept behind CTR. So that is why I am giving you some basic calculations over here. It's not mathematical. On the platform, you are going to see it there by default. You do not have to do it mathematically. This metric is there in your Google Ads platform, and you just have to find it out, and you have to see that, okay, now my ad is getting this much of CTR, or my campaign is getting this much of average CTR. That is the only thing that you have to see over there, and you do not have to measure or do not have to calculate the way I am doing it, right? So the example that I've taken is like 10 clicks and 100 impressions, and for the percentage we are going to multiply it with 100. So this time it will become 10%. So the CTR is 10%, which means that for every 100 impressions that my ad is making, I am getting 10 clicks. For every 10 impressions my ad is making, I am getting 1 click. So this is basically the CTR, the click through rate. So now click-through rate should be positive or should be negative. I mean to say that if your click-through rate is increasing, is it a good signal for you? Or if your click-through rate is decreasing, is it a good signal for you? Definitely, if our click-through rate is increasing, it's a good signal for me, which means that click-through rate is a positive metric and we should work on increasing our click-through rate, right? We want that if my this particular ad, the ad number 2, got 100 impressions, we do not want only 10 clicks. We want to increase these clicks. Why? Because see, if this 100 impressions remains constant over here, and I got 10 clicks, and let's compare it with another thing. I got 20 clicks with respect to 100 impressions, and let's convert it into percentage. So this will become 20%. It will cancel out, right? Another thing, it will cancel out and it will become 10%, right? So is this a good option for us? Is this a good result for us? Or is this a good result for us? Definitely, this one is a good result for us. So increase in CTR is a good signal for us, or decrease in a CTR is a good signal for us. We should put things together in such a way that they basically increase our CTR, or we should put our efforts in such a way that they basically increase our CTR, or we should put our efforts in a way that it should decrease our CTR. So guys, we must put some efforts to increase our CTR, as it is a positive metric. So this is the mathematical calculation behind CTR. So there might be different cases, right? Every time, it's not like that you will be getting 10% of CTR, you will be getting 5% of CTR, you will be getting 7% of CTR, right? So what is the perfect CTR? What should we aim for? What is the benchmark over there? What should we try for, right? Is there any benchmark? Is there any benchmark which is defined with respect to CTR that, okay, this is a good CTR? When we say, suppose if we are talking about class 10th students, right? And if there are two students and one student got like 75%, other one got 80%, right? So we have some benchmarks over there. Like if anyone is getting more than 60%, which means that he or she is an average student, right? If anyone is getting more than 90%, which means that he is a good student, or she is a good student, which means that the benchmarks are there. Now, when we talk about the CTR, when we say the click-through rate, so there might be the cases like we will be getting 5% of CTR, we will be getting 6% of CTR, we will be getting 2% of CTR, 1% of CTR. Now, which one is a good CTR? What we should aim for, and what is the appropriate CTR where we should stick ourselves, right? So, now this CTR basically depends on the different industries that you are working for, the different niches that you are working for. It does not remain constant. I mean, no one can say that, okay, 2%, if you are getting 2% of CTR, it's a good thing. If you are getting 5% of CTR, it's a good thing. It actually depends on the type of the ad also. Like if you are running search ad, there is some different kind of benchmark, the average benchmark with respect to the industries. Like in automobile industry, the CTR can be somewhere around 3% or 4%. It is considered as a good CTR. If you are in money making industry, if you are in digital marketing industry and you are running some ad, and if you are getting 5% of CTR or 8% of CTR, then it is considered as a good CTR. So there are standards, but they are industry wise, right? So, and also there are standard according to the ad type, right? So the standard of search ad, or the benchmark of the search ad, will be totally different from the benchmark of display ad, right? Got my point? So now, a good Google Ads click-through rate is 4 to 5%. Now, this is one is for search. That is what written over here. A good Google Ads click-through rate is somewhere around 5%. So if you are getting 5% of CTR, it's a good thing, right? Overall, it's a good thing on the search network. But on display network, it is basically somewhere around 1%. So if you are getting 1% on display network, you are running display ads. That is what we discussed in the first video, that there are search ads also, and then there are display ads also. So if you are running display ads, and you are aiming for 4 to 5% of CTR, that is almost not possible, right? Because on display network, we have seen that because you are basically forcing people to see your ad. So the CTR is generally quite low when you compare it with the search network, right? In search network, the concept is it's like inbound marketing, and in display network, it's like outbound marketing, where you are reaching to your prospects or reaching to your customers, and you are targeting them, right? They are not coming to you. You are going to them. So when you are going to them, there are less chances that they will click on your ad. But when they are coming to you, when they are looking for the services or the products that you provide, there are high chances that they are going to click on your ad, right? So this is the difference between the CTR on search network and the CTR on display network. So definitely CTR on search network will be higher with respect to, or when we compare it with CTR of display network, right? Because of the intent, right? The intent of searcher on the search network is, it's more inclined towards your product or services, or they are coming after your product or services. They are actually looking for, there is high intent, which basically makes the CTR, the average CTR, higher over here, right? So this is the concept behind what is a good CTR. Now, if we talk about the average CTR industry-wise, you can see the average CTR industry-wise is given over here on both the networks, which is search network and another one is display network. So we can see, we can figure out something over here like education, right? In education industry, the average search CTR is somewhere around 4%. Let's make it round figure, somewhere around 4%. And it is somewhere around 0.6%, the display network CTR, right? So if we average it out, right, if we average it out, this thing, the average CTR, if we are going to average this out, this will be coming to somewhere around 4 to 5%, which is the average CTR of the search network. And this one is the average of all the industries, right? Got my point? So the CTR varies from industry to industry. And let's pick up the lowest CTR, which is like 2.4 over here, 2.4 over here. Let's pick up the average lowest CTR over here, which is 2.09, right? This one, the technology industry is having lowest CTR in search network with respect to search network. So if you are running ads of technology industry, you might not get those kind of results, right? Or you might not get crazy CTR, you might not get good CTR, because average CTR of technology industry on search network is not pretty good, right? It is way less than the average, right? So average CTR, if we talk about the average CTR of search network, overall search network of all the industries, is 4 to 5%, and you are only getting 2% in technology stream or technology industry, which makes it as like half of what your average CTR is, right? Similarly, over here also it is like 0.39, right? And let's see if there is any other lower value. No, it is not there, right? So you on both the networks, on search network also and on display network also, the ads that you are running in technology category are not getting that much of attention, right? And when I say they are not getting that much of attention, which means that the CTR is not very good over there, right? So now that's it for this topic, CTR, right? What is CTR and what is the average CTR? How do we calculate CTR and why CTR is important, and do we need to really care about CTR? Yes, we need to really care about CTR. Because increasing the CTR indicates that, yes, people are loving our ads, or people are basically clicking on our ads, which means that, which indicates that, okay, our ad or whatever the campaigns we are setting are relevant to the searcher's query, right? If they are relevant to the searcher's query, then only we will be getting desired CTR. So that's it for this particular video. See you in the next video. Till then, goodbye.